present our research called A Global Approach to Improve the Mathematical Level of Engineering Students. My partner Eugenio Ramos and I, we belong to the Department of Applied Mathematics of the University of Salamanca. We work at the Politécnica High School of Zamora. In this work, we have analyzed what is the situation of the initial knowledge in mathematics at the Engineering studies. This level is clearly unsatisfactory. We have done this, investigation using a specifically designed test who has given us the generation of groups of students with similar mathematical deficiency. This mathematical deficiency are based on the way of entrance at university. The possible solution to these mathematical problems should be done for each group because each group has a different problematic and a different situation, a different kind of solution for this situation. We want to develop a global approach to solve this situation. This global approach includes various parts. One of them is the use of an online tool to improve the mathematical level of some of these students, a group, a specific group. The measure of this improvement by means of a self-confidence test and the qualification of the students. And a strategy to prevent the most common mathematical errors found in written examination. To do that, we are going to use another methodology, a participative classroom sessions. So we are going to work into taking into account the frame of the Spanish educational legislation. This is the frame. The students who can access the university are students from pre-graduate studies, high school, and students from vocational training modules. The mathematical background of this group is different, really different from each group. Students from high school have a specific mathematical background and it's compulsory, this formation. But a group of them, they used to be the ones having the poorest mathematical level, can avoid to take the examination of mathematics before going to the university. They do that because they want to maximize their score and to access to enter the university. The students from vocational training modules have a bad mathematical program. We have analyzed the mathematical level of the students coming to the Polytechnic High School. My high school is in this University, University of Salamanca, and we have seen six engineering degrees from different areas. The first step is always to make a diagnosis of the situation of our student. The diagnosis should be as accurate as possible. This step is very important because as we are teachers, we don't have information about the way of entrance of our students. The information that the university gives to us is, you can see it, this is the type of students. You can see what's her number, the another number, kind of subject, times they have So the official information does not include data about the way of access of our students. So we want to make that diagnosis and we have designed a specific test. This specific test includes a header when we can have this kind of data. Here you see high school, vocational training modules, if you have take the examination and so on. So the test includes not only some items to measure mathematical concepts or processes, but this kind of information that we need about the way of accessing at the university. So we can detect the presence of three groups of students who should be treated separately. This is a difference between this study and other studies because most of teachers make initial tests, but usually the results are treated globally. Taking into account the weight of entrance of these students to the university, I think we think this is an important point for the level, mathematical level of our students. For example, this is the results, the global results. Our students should calculate the derivative of some functions. These are the results. Correct answer, no correct answer, no answers. But if you analyze the way of entrance of these students, the results are much clearer. This is the student that have take the examination of mathematics before going to the university. So the correct answer is really bigger than to the other groups. This is the group of students who has not done the examination of mathematics before going to the university. And this is vocational training modules. You can see majority of them don't answer these questions. The worst results, of course, are found in vocational training modules group. So the first step is to design a specific online tool to solve the situation. Nevertheless, the results of the other groups are not very good. These students should answer this question. So we need another approach to these students. For these students, what we have done is to focus on the most common mathematical errors that these students commit in written examination. So we have tried to correct these errors by means of some session, classroom session, dedicated to fix the attention about these topics. So this is the global approach, two levels of actuation, because the problematic is different from them. This is the results for the group of vocational training modules. This results has been presented yet. We have done analog tools, we have designed this, and we have the, you can have a detailed description in these references if you want. If I would like to remember some results, the group's performance examination have improved, and the average qualification have raised. And the teacher satisfaction has very good results, because all of them, they say the course have been useful to understand mathematics at the classroom. So I think it has been successful. This is the second part. An online course is very useful for these students, but we need a second step for the examination, and this kind of ability is not very suitable for the use of an online material, because this kind of training needs an immediate feedback. It's easier to give this feedback in classroom. So we have designed these sessions, and then we have analyzed the impact of this initiative. This session goes with this schema. We have compelled the students to complete the solution of a procedure with a typical error in an anonymous sheet. Then we have collected the sheet, we have mixed them, and we have distributed them again, so that the student is going to correct the results of another student, as they were the teacher, in a classroom session. And then the teacher has solved the process at the blackboard, saying, "This is take care here, this is an error, look at what the sheet, and correct this," as they were the teacher. Then we have measured the impact of this initiative comparing the errors for two consecutive academic years. And we have used a classification of errors to quantify it. And then we have quantified the absence of answer. These are the results for some topics. These two topics have been not trained. So the errors have maintained more or less similar, stable from these two consecutive years. These other topics have been trained in the classroom session. It has been an improvement. This is the part of the students who have made this error at this academic year, and this is this present academic year who have done this initiative. So it has been an improvement. And this is the results for question, well, no answer questions. Here we need to distinguish between theoretical questions and algorithmic questions. Theoretical questions have improved, but less than practical algorithmic questions. So this kind of session, this kind of procedures, are especially good for training processes. Not exactly theoretical ideas. We need another kind of approach. So within that kind of classroom session are an effective tool to improve the mathematical performance of our students, because the results show a decrease of the main errors, or the main failures, on the number of questions left unanswered have decreased. So I think this kind of global approach is a good approach to solve this level, this mathematical level. But the first step should be to diagnose accurately what the situation, and then to design different tools for different problems. An online tool is a useful tool for some problems, but another kind of errors should be trained in another way, for example, using participative classroom session. That's all. Thank you very much.